Hello Redditors, today Reddit Top Posts will present one of the top r Ask Reddit topics. You will find the best Reddit comments of this fun story. If you like this video, please subscribe for more Ask Reddit content. Enjoy! Service members of Reddit. What is your worst military wife story? I am a military spouse, but worked as a DoD employee with the Marines. Got a call that a military spouse was in the hospital, her place on base housing had gotten broken into. The 9-month pregnant spouse was raped and beaten and taken by ambulance to the hospital. The assault caused a miscarriage. I was devastated and went to the hospital with several officers and the Marines' chain of command. One of the nurses tending her looked me in the eye and said, "I am very interested in how this is going to play out." I was so confused. The 9-month pregnant rape and assault victim was given an ultrasound and blood work performed upon being admitted to the hospital. She hadn't been pregnant. She wasn't raped. Her due date was the next day and she's been faking the pregnancy the whole time. She beat herself up and carved herself up with a knife, then made up the rape story resulting in miscarriage as a way to cover up the 9 months of lying to her husband about being pregnant. I've never seen this level of crazy until 3 months later, when said Marine reunited with bad SHT crazy girl even after all that. Standing gate guard in Washington, D.C., officer's wife drives through the gate and presents her ID. I wave her through. She doesn't move, asking me if I forgot something. I said no, I didn't believe I did. She said I forgot to salute her, pointing to the blue sticker on her windshield. I leaned close to her windshield and saluted the sticker, wishing it a good afternoon. I got removed from that duty. I was stationed at FT Noxkey in the late 80s. A soldier's child turned up missing. DMN near every solider on FT Knox was looking for this kid. We looked for days. Kid never turns up. I leave and move on. Several years later, I'm sent back to FT Knox. Out of the blue, a bunch of activity is happening at a park several miles away. The little girl turned up, some of her anyway, and it turns out that the soldier's wife, the girl's stepmom, killed the girl. The soldier came home, found out, and hid the body in the park. The whole case was solved because the older sister of the girl was starting to get worried she was next. Told a teacher who got the police involved. That the worst I've heard of, over 20 plus years in the army. Plenty of cheating, plenty of other stuff. Saw a newer airman with no belt on. I asked, "Why don't you have a belt?" He said he can't afford one, so I give him $5 and tell him to go get a belt. A few weeks later, I see him at Ruby Tuesday cleaning tables. I ask around and apparently his wife was growing weed in base housing and he got kicked out of the military. He swore he didn't know what she was doing. I got accosted by a dependent at a Home Depot parking lot because I parked in her space. I parked in a veteran's spot at Home Depot. I am a veteran, I had my two toddlers with me, and the spot was next to a cart stall. As I am pulling my kids out of the car, this lady walks up to me and starts asking me questions. Simple stuff, but nothing out of the ordinary, but I leave my kids in the car to be safe. She then starts asking about my veteran status, which was weird, but not bad. I told her I'm a sergeant in the 123 Trans Brigade, not real, part of the Natty Guard. Well, my husband's a lieutenant col, which means he's a higher rank. She said, "Well, if he's a commissioned officer, he's already a higher rank." I said, "So you should give me your spot." I was dumbfounded. WTF. I told her to pound sand, to which she wanted my info, rank, name, etc. So I said, "Yeah, sure, and I'll make sure to give you the spot next time." No SHT. 3 days later, I get a call from my NCOIC. "Hey, Sergeant Stutton Post. Do you know a LTC's face?" To which, "No, I don't." "Okay. I got a LTC in my office looking for you, said it's important." "Alright." Mine Koenig puts me on speakerphone. "Hey Sarnd, this is LTC's face. I wanted to apologize for my spouse's behavior the other day. I jokingly told her she could parade up and down the street ordering other soldiers to do things, and I had no idea she would take it literally. I'm sorry this happened and I hope we can put this behind us." I accepted his apology, because up to this point, no CO has ever apologized for their actions. Chill list. LTC. Ever. I got restationed back in the States from Germany. I flew my German girlfriend over and we ended up getting married. She went back to Germany 4 days later and I never saw her again. Lol. Whack. Oh, I'm gonna post some of my friend's highlights. She was the midwife on an Air Force base. Delivered lots of babies. Colonel brought his 16-year-old daughter in because she was pregnant. Turns out the father was a new junior enlisted. He did not last long in the military. Dude's wife left him and moved in with her boyfriend off base while he was deployed. She got knocked up. Since they were still married, she was still going to the base for medical care. Their divorce wasn't final by her due date, so she still got to go on base and deliver. Her soon-to-be ex-husband, the military guy, had his buddies in security forces put a security flag on his soon-to-be ex-wife's boyfriend. The boyfriend couldn't be on base for the birth of his child. And, always the favorite, babies coming out with the wrong ethnic background of the father was at least a once-a-year thing. Posting on behalf of my husband. Worst, they came back from a 15-month tour in Iraq. His platoon sergeant went home to find another man living in his house, with his wife and kids. His kids, toddlers, were calling the guy daddy. When he walked in, his wife basically said, "Yay. I want a divorce. I'm with him now." Worst part was the platoon sergeant and new daddy, kinda, worked together, but was one of the few who stayed behind for clerical stuff while the rest deployed. Yes, I know this is absolutely against the rules. This was when SHT was the Wild West and a DUI was an unofficial requirement for E6. EDA, I asked my husband what happened after this. He doesn't know what happened to Jody, aka deployment replacement daddy. The husband threatened to take the kids and kick her onto the street, which he definitely had grounds to do. Instead, she agreed to on-demand SX and threesomes, including summoning a prostitute if he wanted one and helping him keep it on the DL. While delivering our fourth baby at a military hospital, we were talking to one of the nurses about infidelity and crazy things she had witnessed. She told us about a woman coming in with her husband for a C-section that was not scheduled. The woman insisted that she was scheduled for a C-section that day. They did an ultrasound and found that she was 3 months pregnant, not 9 months pregnant. She was willing to deliver a baby 6 months early, so it would appear the conception lined up with her husband's mid-tour leave. Oh man, so many. One friend in the Corps, a first-term sergeant who hated every minute he was in uniform. He re-enlisted so she could go to school. Left for deployment after re-enlistment, came back to a divorce and a drained bank account. Had another sergeant who met his wife while he and like 7 other guys were running a gangbang on her. He decided he needed to marry her. So many SHD stories there, but I mean, he probably deserved them. Cause I mean, wow. One evening while I was on staff duty, my then wife decided that I was cheating on her and not, in fact, at work. I was totally at work, nor had I ever cheated on her, so she texts me and says I'm going to go to the barracks and FCK the first soldier I see. I was so checked out of the relationship at this point, I was just waiting to get out to leave her, so I didn't bother responding. She showed up at the barracks and got turned away by CQ because she used her dependent ID to try to check into the barracks, and couldn't tell them who she was there to visit. A guy in my shop, Air Force, deployed to Iraq for 4.5 months. Before he left, he signed over general power of attorney to his wife. While he was gone, she started defking another guy in our shop, then signed the divorce paperwork as his power of attorney and his rights to see his kids, as well as draining his bank account. She went to live with the other guy in my shop and his friend off base. They were both arrested for check fraud when trying to pass off a check that was the roommate's in the shop at on base. The guy she divorced eventually got full custody of the kids and the other guy in my shop got kicked out of the F. There were other stories of cheating and all of that kind of SHT, but this one takes the cake. She actively worked to ruin his life when all he did was love his kids and get deployed to Iraq. Don't give anyone general power of attorney, ever. I don't care how much you trust them or how much you think they love you. Don't do it. You can give them specialized power of attorney that only allows them to handle your affairs that you very specifically need them to handle. Our neighbors, too, brought us some stories. 1. Unit deployed and she met a new guy. Used power of attorney to divorce the husband overseas and married the new guy so quick she was able to stay on base in the same house. First husband came home and ended up being in the same platoon as second husband, who now lived in his house with his kids and all his belongings. 2. When we first moved in on base, we had a neighbor that was super friendly. Wife told us she had cancer, so her brother was staying with her to take care of her. We think nothing of it. A few months later, they moved out to live off base. Normal thing, so no reason to be skeptical. Fast forward a few months and I'm shoveling the driveway and a guy from next door comes over to say hi. I say hi and welcome him as a new neighbor. Has not a new neighbor, has had that house for a couple years. I got confused and asked about the woman who had moved out recently. He told me that woman was his wife, the brother was her lover, she didn't have cancer, and she spent all his money on Farmville then moved out with everything they owned. Dude and my platoon's wife falsely accused her ex-MP boyfriend of rape. Went as far as stabbing a mattress and swallowing condom to set him up. Dude spends weeks in jail before being cleared of all charges. When it comes to light, it was crazy lady vindictive bullshit. She amped up the crazy. She handed her friend her and my platoon mate's baby through a window at night while they watched a movie. Platoon mate went to check on the baby and it was missing. Prompted the first Amber Alert in Alaska history. She tried to pin it on the MP as some sort of act of vengeance. I can only imagine what the poor dude was thinking when the cops came to him with this. He was very quickly eliminated a subject and they figured out that the baby was safe rather quickly. I have two. First, I was the witness to one of my soldiers' wedding. It was a typical Joe wedding in that it took place midday, at a Wings and Things, during the lucky bride's lunch break. The mother of the bride owned said Wings and Things but refused to attend the ceremony despite being at work that day. It was pretty amazing. Second, I was at officer candidate school with an army hot blonde. She was a deployment 9/10 and everybody hit on her. She was drowning in attention but it was all for naught because she was married to a Green Beret or something. Well, all that attention finally got to her and she started sleeping with the cadets. It got to the point of her and another married female getting nailed in a hotel room at the same time and they reportedly high-fived mid-coitus. About 3/4 of the way through the course she started to put on a little weight and it sure seemed like her belly was growing faster than the rest of her. About 4 weeks before graduation it came out that she was, in fact, pregnant with who the FCK knows baby. Not long after graduation I heard that her marriage to Mr. SF did not survive the encounter. Long story short, someone, A, in my unit walked in on his wife cheating on him with someone else, B, from our unit. They separate. She moves in with B and leaves the unit. 8 months later. We return from a deployment, and A goes on one date with a girl, his ex-wife finds out and calls the first SGT. A gets charged with adultery and reduced in rank while B only got switched to a different unit. Hope this counts. My grandfather was stationed in Germany where he met my grandmother. They got married in Germany and she moved back to the States with him, where his family was absolutely not very happy about it. His mother actually offered to buy him a brand new car if she married a nice American woman instead. Obviously my grandma wasn't too happy about that and decided the best course of action was to have a second wedding in the US to prove she wasn't going anywhere. They were married 55 years and she's still living in the original family home, she really didn't go anywhere. My brother-in-law was on both sides of SHD cheating stories. He married a woman he chatted to online for a few weeks when he was 19. Then he had to go to Iraq. A month after he left she told him that he got her pregnant. He comes home after 6 months then she has the baby. The baby definitely is not his. Fast forward 10 years. He's married to an awesome chick we all like. She works a job and takes care of everything around the house. He cheats on her with a 18-year-old girl that worked at Sonic. She catches him and leaves for a weekend to go stay with her sister to figure out what to do. He puts all her stuff in cardboard boxes out under the carport and moves in the new girl. Long story, doctor got tricked, married an already married woman, lost everything. So I was assigned to Pensacola for some training. I wasn't going to be there long and shouldn't have dated. 21-year-old me was stupid. I met a girl off base and we started to date. She loved that I was in the military while constantly saying she didn't like military guys. Should have been a red flag. She literally pretended to be the perfect girlfriend. Whatever hobby I mentioned she said I'm into that too. She did everything possible to act like we were a perfect match. She even said she worked as a female office manager when I told her I joined because I like to help people. 4 months goes by and I get orders to Cannon AFB in New Mexico. I mentioned that I have to go soon. She knew I was just there temporarily, and she starts hinting at wanting to go with me. Thinking I'm in a really good relationship, I agree. We get to New Mexico and I rent us a place. I was actually supposed to live on base in dorms for about a year until I ranked up to senior airman. Things between us go downhill immediately after moving into our place. She suddenly didn't enjoy doing anything I did and had a really bad attitude. She said it was just nerves from moving so far. Fast forward 2 months and I'm getting bitched out by my captain for living off base without authorization. I explained my situation and he said to send her back or get married. Yup, you guessed it. Got married. We were married for 9 years. She was a miserable cunt the whole time. Refused to get a job, so I had to 100% support her. Turns out she really couldn't get a job because she just had a GED and her only work experience is as a receptionist for maintenance at a trailer park. She lied about the FEMA job. Right before our 9-year mark, she begs me to get out of the military so we can move back to Florida. Her grandmother died and she said we had to take care of her grandfather. Stupidly, I did it. We get to Florida and her grandfather is fine. We only saw him a handful of times over the course of 2 years. Eventually I catch on that she's been cheating on me and I throw her crap out of my house and she moves in with her boyfriend. Apparently she wanted to go back to Florida because there were some guys there she wanted to hook up with. When I met her she was 140 and blew up to 350 within 2 years of us being together, so I really had no interest in her ex-Zuali. Plus she was a bitch. Initiated divorce and she wouldn't cooperate. She kept breaking into my house with her boyfriend and looting my place. I'd bring home groceries and they'd be gone the next time I left the house. Cops wouldn't do anything because we were married and same with landlord. I decided to move and she caught wind. I'm at school and she clears my house out. I go to her place to confront her and she calls the cops. I get accused of burglary and battery and the police believe her because the sociopath can cry on command. I end up getting a plea deal to withhold adjudication of a felony and 3 years of probation. My lawyer convinced me to take it. During the process I find out she was never legally married to me. She was, and still is, married to a career criminal up in Michigan. She had me take care of her for nearly a decade, while miserable the whole time, and she heavily utilized her medical benefits from being a military dependent. She was never actually my legal wife. My PO felt bad and I was able to get off my probation at 1 year and 5 months. Charges were lessened so they could be sealed and eventually expunged. She literally has suffered zero consequences for what is basically bigamy with fraud, a class felony. Florida won't help because they said New Mexico has jurisdiction. New Mexico won't do anything because she is out of state.